When we are building in a composite zone, one needs to understand the climatic context, the diversity in the overall area with respect to temperature, with respect to microclimate, with respect to the materials with which you can build, and most of all, you need to respect the budget of the client. Okay, the site is probably 3 kilometers from Farooqnagar, which is a small village. It is very, very popular because Britishers used to extract a lot of salt from here. So the soil over here is pretty bad with respect to landscape and with respect to construction also. For a boys' one, they were looking to accommodate 300 students in a very linear block, which was given in the master plan. And in the girls' hostel, we have to provide accommodation for 120 girls. The boys' hostel was pretty much open and approachable by all at all times. The girls' hostel was supposed to be a site within a site kind of a situation, wherein security was primary concern. So there are predominantly two entries to the site. It's a pretty odd shaped site. The north of the site is slightly angled like that, and that's the predominant sun path. They have already built block number one, which is their first academic block, which is 50,000 square feet of built up area, and then block number two, which is having 40,000 square feet of area. And in the given master plan, they had defined this linear block over here as the first given location for the boys' hostel, and this linear block over here as a given location for the girls' hostel. The width of the building was not much, so it was very, very difficult to build in courtyards or a larger volume cutouts, because it's really left us with no space. And the building height was also restricted because they didn't want it to cross the 15 meter height limit. So in the boys' hostel, instead of a given linear block, which was split into four levels, we twisted the block in the front, and that twist created two very interesting spaces. The one facing south, we call it as summer court, as it provides you the required shade during the peak hot afternoon in summers. Sun angle is pretty high, and in winters the sun angle becomes low, and it is a very pleasant space to enjoy the winter sun as well. Whereas the terrace on the north gives you some solar exposure during the winter from the south sun because of the depth of the terrace, as well as during the evenings, it's a very pleasant space to look out into the central lawn. It also starts creating shade on the facade, whereas in the girls' hostel, it was close to the boundary wall, and there is others' property on the other side, from where there was a threat of overlooking privacy and also somebody, you know, trespassing and create nuisances. We split the building into four. On the north, we built balconies, wherein we then started putting the screen. Firstly, it was giving you the sense of privacy from the neighbors. And the second thing was that it saves you and protects you from the diffuse radiation and the convective and conductive gain from the air temperature outside. On the south, we created a court which was enclosed by an outer envelope skin, which was again a jali, permeable jali, which gives you a glimpse of the campus outside. So it doesn't look like a boxed in situation all in all. But when you look from outside to inside, it blocks the view towards the girls' hostel. In the courtyard, then we thought that we will house One of the fire escapes, which remains as an unusable space throughout the year, and create that into a social space which connects terraces, internal lounge on multiple levels. This was shaded from top from the summer sun, but from this permeable skin, the winter sun penetrates deeper and it actually warms up your room very nicely during winter. So we designed a transitional space in between the inside and the outside on both the edges of the building. In case of boys' hostel, we split the mass to create an entrance fire, which is a beautiful transition space which you see over here. It was then heavily planted to create a very favorable microclimate for outdoor interactions. We designed the edge of the planter to become the seating itself. This space was given to a coffee shop and a stationery shop as well. Once you enter into the building, you enter into a lobby from where you can enter into a common mess, which can accommodate up to 150 students at one time, having a kitchen yard on the back and a main kitchen. On the south, we did a deep overhang to protect the glazing, and on the north, we created a beautiful landscape space where students can then spill out into this, which increased the capacity of the mess to take in more students. We also have the gymnasium, which is not really accessed from inside but from outside, so that it can be used both by girls and the boys. So this is a linear landscape which is creating a continuous plaza where all the social spaces they spill out into. Then on the left hand side, we have double occupancy rooms with attached washrooms. As we move up, there were three essential staircases. Right in the center, we then created an atrium. Here on this floor, you have a triple occupancy room all along on the left hand side and the right hand side. And right in the center along the core, we have shared washroom area. At the eastern end of this linear block, dormitories were designed to give more life to this space. A triple height terrace was designed so that they can come out and have a spill out zone of their own. On the second floor, again, we have three staircases. We have the dorms on the right extreme end along with their terrace court. It keeps on twisting. As you go on the left wing, we then created a beautiful terrace garden, having a very nice view of the central lawn. The third floor is a repetition of what's happening on the second floor. In section, the twisted block on the lower floor, because of its twisted angle, was not receiving any more radiations from the west. We planned a skin, like a blanketed skin, in front of the south and the north facade both, to reduce direct and diffuse radiation. This helps in creating a small transition space on the south and the north, wherein we then housed balconies. So all the rooms in the building were having a balcony which was either opening into the court, which you can see here in the section, or it is opening into this blanketed facade. This helps us in reducing the temperature from outside 45 degrees to inside 32 to 33 degrees. And with ceiling fan on, increase in the thermal comfort zone, we can easily feel like 31 degrees indoors. And that decreases the need of air conditioning in this building altogether. In the linear section, the cool air, which comes from the courtyard, is exposed to the greens and the shaded thermal mass at all times, which cools down the air. And then the cool air enters into the building, and through the atrium, it rises up and the hot air then escapes out. that happens in the center of the building and on the other side where the terrace is given next to the dorms. And there is diffused daylight coming in all parts of the building, so all the corridors were kept daylit at all times. Moving on to the girls' hostel. So you enter from here, where you have the ramp to take you on to the plinth level, and you have this beautiful landscape plaza where you can spill out in the morning or in the evening. It is clubbed with the outdoor dining seating and the pantry. On the ground floor, they have student lounge, which was kept and clubbed right next to the double height lobby. This is then clubbed and opened into the court on the south, which is landscaped. And the planters again are designed so that the edges of the planter became the seating. On the ground floor, internally, you have two bedroom with attached washroom space, having the balconies attached to them. As we move up through the staircase, we get these terraces, which are semi-outdoor lounges, which are connected with the internal or indoor lounges. And from there, you actually access a central corridor, which then feeds into the triple sharing room with a common washroom right in the center of the building. The staircase was a very, very important element. It offers a very dynamic transitional space, a social hub, I would say, which connects students on all floor with each other. We use exposed brickwork as the facade material. It acts as a permanent finish, which doesn't need to be plastered or painted. The second thing was that it is a very effective thermal mass, which has a very, very long life as well. We then wrote a script wherein initially insulation analysis was done on the primary facade, and the input points were then fed into Grasshopper, which gave us the rotation angle to achieve shades all throughout the summer and allow solar penetration during the winters. The biggest problem was how to build this, because it gives us brick which were rotating in all angles. So we couldn't use the mortar because the overlapping surface between the two bricks was pretty less. So we got this custom-made brick made for the site with a single hole, which can actually take a reinforcement bar of 25 mm. We put the bar first into the beam using a Hilti chemical fastener, and then we started laying the bricks right from the top, 20 feet high, till the base, and then it gives us a free opportunity to rotate the brick because you have an axis, and also the bar acts as a very strong binding members between all the bricks. So there is no mortar used in constructing the brick facade of the boys' hostel, which spans 25 feet in height and 250 feet in length, one of the biggest brick jali ever made in Asia, using no cement mortar at all. So we realized that because of the vertical insertion of the brick, you know, the horizontal blockage of solar radiation was not possible. So there was some solar radiations which were able to penetrate through. So it was not 100% effective. The second thing was that we needed a way in which this facade can be built, which increased the overall budget of the project as well. The third thing was that it was not able to control the air movement from the facade as well, and the view out opportunity from this facade was also pretty limited. Then in the girls' hostel, thought of using these 8 inch by 8 inch by 8 inch concrete block. They also act as very effective thermal mass because it is solid on all four sides. It gives you a better opportunity to look out because of the larger openings in the mass. And we started laying them one on top of each other. We didn't actually needed a reinforcement bar because they have enough surface area. So we use a chemical bond to fix one on top of each other. When the air comes in from the outside, it gets compressed, and because it gets compressed and is exposed to this mass which is shaded at all times, the air temperature reduces, and hence you get a cool air on the other side of this module. Because of the high level of salt content in water, we were very limited with respect to the choice of plants we can actually use for landscaping in this zone. So we were only limited to species like inermi or champa, panda. But what we did interestingly was that we converted the front landscape in the girls' hostel as a rainwater harvesting area. Similarly, in the boys' hostel, all the water was taken through the ramp into the forecourt and then was used for recharging the groundwater table. In boys' hostel, when we twist the lower block and the upper block, structurally it becomes a very big challenge, because the vertical columns from the lower block, we couldn't take them up. We then started building these V-shaped columns to reduce the span and the depth of the transfer girder beam. From there on, we started taking the floating columns, which helps in constructing the upper two stories. This V-shaped column was then used as a very important language, very effective in breaking away from the linearity and grid system look of the complete building. And we use that as an element for doing the landscaping in the court as well. So all the planters were derived from the similar system. Similarly, in the girls' hostel, we didn't want it to build a linear staircase. So we actually started creating these twists and bends in the movement angles, which helps in creating a little more dynamic space with respect to the experience, overall experience of the transition space, and also the aesthetics, which were way too different from the building. Once you are in the building, everything is pretty rigid, 90 degrees and straight. Once you come out in the transition space, either in the boys' hostel or the girls' hostel, structurally the whole system changes. So within that tight budget, to create with the limited material palette a building which can offer much more than just being a box, a linear box, was the biggest challenge, which was pleasantly resolved in this case.